That people tell me will never lose, and that is Shakur. People tell me. I hear that all the time. Virgil Ortiz Sr. told me every year. People, you hear that a lot, Shakur?
No. Bam's not losing either. What the fuck?
Bam's not losing, Shakur.
Bam is a beast.
He's fighting Navarrete. 2 pound-for-pound guys going at it. What do you think?
No. They're fighting Valdez. You said Valdez. Fucking
Gallo Estrada. Same shit.
You said Navarrete.
Yeah.
Nah, I don't think nobody
beats
that weight.
Yeah, I'm gonna go
Bam.
Back
in second. Nobody beats Bam.
Nah.
It's all good, but you have a fight announcement. You have a date, right?
July 6th.
Where?
Newark, New Jersey.
Okay, at home. So hopefully everybody knows. Let us know when the tickets go on sale. Where can people get it? July 6th.
I'm gonna post it on my Instagram and my Twitter, but it's not on sale yet.
So Shakur, you just offered Robert and Pete $100,000 a bet. That's a big money bet. They're willing to bet $1,000. $100 is a little much, but. Like I said, I've never heard of a fighter being so confident. Why are you so confident in yourself?
Because I put in the work. All I do is box. All I live is boxing. The same way the fighters that they got stay in the gym, I stay in the gym too. So
you've always been like that?
I'm just confident in myself.
Hold on. Yeah. Hold on. Here's Raymond's dad, really quick, Shakur. So Shakur Stevenson, he offered Robert and Pita $100,000 when he fights your son.
Let's do it. I mean, I'm not going to bet. I don't got that kind of money, bro. But we're willing to fight you. You know, we want to fight
the best. Yeah, I can't wait to make it happen.
Yeah, I want to fight the best, bro. And you are the best, bro. We want to fight you, bro.
Have you ever heard of a fighter willing to bet on himself
$100,000? Bro, we don't have that kind of money, bro. You know? Well, yeah, let's do it.
Bro.
All right, hey. All right, champ. Take it easy. All
right.
But it seems like Shakur... Everybody comes at you on social media. Why is that?
Because they don't know me. They only see the finished product. They don't see like the work I put in. They don't see everything that I do on a daily. So they don't know me.
But once they get to know you, it's different. But I'm saying all these fighters, if I made a list of fighters who called you out, I'd probably be at 20 or 30.
Yeah, but who really is like ready to sign the contracts and really fight? That's the real question. I don't think a lot of dudes can call you out and say your name, but when a contract is presented in front of you, you have a choice to say yes or no, and I don't think a lot of dudes are saying yes.
No, some of it is clout because you're a big name,
and
they know it's not going to happen, but it's going to have people talking, oh, he called out Shakur, and Shakur's going to fight him. But some of it is like, they want to be where you are.
Like, I ain't going to say Williams Zepeda, but Oscar De La Hoya. He said my name 100 times leading up to Zepeda fight. And then after the fight, we reach out and try to make the fight happen. And we say, oh, no, we'll fight you at the end of the year. We don't want to fight you yet. That's clout.
I thought that would be a great fight.
Yeah, but it's like a lot of people clout chasing my name. I think it will be a great fight. I think Zepeda's style brings a different style to the table that I've never seen before in the pros.
He's 32, 33, or 35, whatever it is, with 27 knockouts. He comes forward.
Relentless. He's relentless. That's the one thing he is. He's relentless, and he's big, and he's a good fighter.
By the way, Ryu just got to the gym today. It's his first day in camp. He's going to have a rematch with Dos Santos. What do you think? How does he do with him?
De Los Santos beats Ryu.
Why? It's a rematch.
Because De Los Santos is the better boxer. I think that he's a real good boxer, technically. And I don't think Ryo is technically as sound as De Los Santos. But he got a puncher's chance, and he dropped De Los Santos in the last fight. So if he could catch him, then they could get him.
Oscar Valdez looked great this weekend.
Yeah.
And that's a fighter you shared the ring with as well. And it shows how great you are, because he's very talented, Valdez, and he's all heart. You saw that.
I like the way that no matter what happens to him, he don't lay down. I think that he comes back stronger. And I think that he's going to be hard to deal with for a lot of guys at 130 pounds.
Were you surprised by Pitbull's performance?
Nah, I told everybody. I knew that was going to happen. I knew stylistically that Pitbull have a way better style than Rolly. I think that Rolly is awkward. Strong, but Pitbull is relentless. He come forward, and it was just stylistically a bad matchup for Rolly.
So right now, you're getting ready for your next fight. You still have a few months around. Do you know, are you going to have your new shoes out from Reebok by fight night?
Yeah, I should have him out by the time we get in the ring on fight night. So hopefully the fans and everybody could go get some. And young kids that are coming up, I hope that we have some out for them too.
So, Shukur, it's been a very exciting weekend. A lot of big fights, a lot of championships. Terrence Crawford was in line for Fondora, but it looks like they're going to go with Earl. But if Terrence does fight Fondora, what happens?
It's going to be weird, though, because I've seen the WBO and whatever belt he got.
WBC.
The WBC. They said that he got a couple of days to make the fight with Terrence. So will he release the belt and fight Earl, or is he going to...
I guess if he fights Earl, he has to vacate.
Oh, I mean, if he's doing that, then, he would probably be doing it for money reasons.
That's what his manager told me. They want to fight Earl because it's big, for them it's bigger money.
Yeah, it's all on the fighters. I mean, that would make sense for them, but I think that a lot of people don't want to fight Terrence Crawford just because they're not good at it.
Now, I got to ask you a funny question. You know a lot of celebrities.
Yeah.
Do you know anyone that partied with P. Diddy?
Nah, I don't know nobody that partied with P. Diddy.
Just one boxer that we all know, but that's about it.
Yeah, I seen him in there, seen him with him, but I don't know. I don't know where that was at. I don't know. I stay out of stuff that's not really my business.
Yeah, no, but that's a crazy story, though, the whole story. Like, 50 Cent, who is a big fan of yours, by the way, he always talks about
it. I'm a big fan of 50 Cent. I'm a huge fan of 50 Cent.
He's a big boxing guy.
He's the GOAT.
Yeah, he's very talented. Who's going to walk you out for your next fight? You already have the biggest names walk you out.
I don't know. It's going to be a surprise. If I get who I want, it's going to be a big surprise. It's going to be very entertaining and fun to watch.
I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.
But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.